Hello guys, in this video you will learn how to use the select tool in AltRex. Select tool is basically used to select some of the column from your input data set. Select tool is also used to define the length of the variables present in your data set, as well as rename the variables present in your data set as per your requirement. Let me just quickly show you the data set I am using. So I am using a store transaction data set, which consists of variables like purchase date, order ID, customer ID, store city, store region, sales amount, and units, right? So in order to use the select tool, go to the preparation tab, select, drag and drop the select tool from here. Make sure this is linked to your input data set. It will open up configuration panel. In configuration panel, it will ask you about the variables you want to select, and as well as you can change the type and type size, and you can also rename the variable if you want. So right now, since order ID is a unique identifier for each order, I am not interested in selecting the purchase date. So I will uncheck this. I will uncheck this unknown column. So I want this order ID, customer ID, store city, store region, sales amount, and sales unit as the final variables present in my final data set. Now, it also gives me the option to choose the variables as well as variable type. So in variable type, you can click the drop down menu, right? And then from here, you can select the type of variable which you want to select. For example, for customer ID, I don't want VW string. I want V string, which is a variable string, and size of this is not required to be 255. The optimal size would be something around 25 or 50. So let it be 50. Similarly, I will change the store city to V string, again size to 50, because this 255 is not the optimal size. Store region is also a string, so I will again choose V string, and from here I can select the size to 50 again. For sales amount and unit, you can choose other options as well, but right now let it be double. If you scroll a little bit right, here it is giving you the option to write the new name of the variables, right? So instead of say sales amount, I want to write it as sales in dollar, and for units let it be num items sold. Right now, once I hit this run button, right, it will run the workflow and will select only those records checked in the configuration panel, and it will make the changes accordingly. Right, if I click on the output of this select tool, you can see that your first column is now order ID, second is customer ID, third is store city, fourth is store region, then sales in dollar and number of items sold. So if you can carefully observe, your variable name is also changed. Variable name is also changed, and your size has also been changed to the required size. Let me just zoom it a little bit. And if I go to metadata, you can see that the customer ID has been changed to variable string, store city is changed to variable string and 50 size, store region is selected to variable string and 50 size, right? So this is an alternative of the autofill tool, right? So if you go to my video on autofill tool is also used to change the variable type and size. You can do that using the select tool, as well as you can use select tool to select the records as well as to rename the record. So you can use select tool in four different ways, or to serve four different purposes. I hope you understood this. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe to our channel.